US President Joe Biden has invited former presidents Barack Obama and Bill Clinton to join his election fundraiser in New York City. More than $39 million was hauled in for Joe Biden's re-election campaign. Clinton took aim at Donald Trump, labelling his ideas as old and out of shape. The fundraiser was interrupted for a short time as protesters against the war in Gaza climbed on stage. Let's head to the United States now, and joining me live is Republican strategist Colin Reed. Colin, it was a pretty powerful stage.
Sure was, and it'll definitely raise a lot of money, but I think it also calls into question a lot of the challenges that President Biden faces. I mean, as hard as it may be to believe, Bill Clinton is 4 years younger than Joe Biden, and he was elected 30 years ago. So when you bring in people who are relics of the past and you yourself are viewed as being too old for the job by almost 9 in 10 Americans, you're setting up a nice contrast for your opponent. And Donald Trump wasted little time by making the point that while they were at the glitzy fundraiser with all the Hollywood elite, he was attending the funeral of a fallen police officer not far away in New York City. So it was a nice split screen for the two challengers.
Yeah, that argument may work for Donald Trump if he was 57 years old, but he's not. He's older than Bill Clinton himself.
Well, he's the same age, but the point is he's younger.
He's slightly older.
But the point is he's younger than Joe Biden, and it's less about how the actual number, and it's how they conduct themselves. And this is the challenge that voters are being asked to grapple with. Should they believe what Joe Biden is saying, or should they believe their lying eyes in terms of him being fit and ready for the job? And they've made it pretty clear. So look, Father Time, undefeated, not going to change. You don't know when gets any younger. So it's just something that Biden's got to live with. And the only chance they really have is just to make Trump so untenable, unpalatable, just unelectable, that people somehow hold their noses and pull the lever for Biden again.
Well, that's sort of happening as well, isn't it? Because although he's had the bond dropped in a cash figure, there's drama after drama for Donald Trump in the courts at the moment, which he's trying to navigate along with standing for the president in November.
That's right. I guess he got a win because the bond was dropped. But still, if you're a candidate for office, you want to be spending more time in debate rooms than you do courtrooms. And unfortunately that for him, that's not going to change between now and then. Now, up until now, all of this, the perceived injustices against him in the court of law have only helped him in the court of public opinion. But that's with a primary audience. That's very different than what he's about to go now face in a general election, where it's less about winning over the people, the hearts and minds of those who are with him, and trying to pull off some of those Biden voters. But I always remind people, the 2020 election was decided by less than 50,000 votes. In a country of more than 300 million, it was decided by 50,000 votes in 5 states. And it's going to happen that way again. It will be a nail biter. It will be close. And all these little things matter as we get closer and closer to the actual election day.
Colin, there's a running theme amongst many saying that most Americans didn't want this battle. And from looking outside in, a lot of people are thinking, well, are these the two best you can come up with?
Hard to blame them. In a country of this much many talented people that we've got a rematch that literally 7 in 10 Americans do not want. The old saying, an unsustainable situation won't be sustained, is one that I think a lot of people have been drawn to in this situation. But at the same time, these guys cruise to their respective nominations. It's difficult, absent an act of God or perhaps a judge, to see how this doesn't happen, but you never know. But look, there's going to be a continued chatter for third party candidates, whether it's someone on the no labels ticket or whether it's Robert Kennedy Jr. That's why there's so much interest. That's why there's so much palace intrigue. That's why when another candidate not named Biden or Trump pops up, they get this inordinate amount of attention, because people do not want this rematch. They didn't really want it in 2020, frankly, and they want it even less 4 years later.
The economy is looking pretty good, which is good news for the sitting government.
The economy is looking good on paper. The challenge the sitting government faces is people don't really feel that good about it. And, you know, perception is reality in life, and certainly in politics. There was a report today, inflation's coming down. It's still not where it needs to be. And people are still really unhappy about the price of groceries, about the price of gasoline has gone way up over here. It remains really out of reach for many to buy a home. So yeah, sure, on paper, if you talk to an economist, they'll tell you that everything's rosy. But if you talk to people who are balancing budgets, they'll give you a far different story. And when it comes to the political ballot, I take the opinions over the latter than the former any day.
A really sad story in so many ways. The horrifying scenes of the Baltimore Bridge collapse has been a huge story this week, Cole.
Terrible. I think it's the eighth or ninth largest port in the country. Lives were lost, which is most important. The scene of that thing coming crashing down was jarring to many. There's still a lot more questions than there are answers. It's about how it happened, who was at fault. I'm sure those who are driving the ship, you know, have questions to answer about their role. And look, it's going to be a big, expensive job. And I think infrastructure is one of those things. It used to be a bipartisan issue. We'll see if it is now. Somehow President Biden has said the federal government is going to pick up the tab for the whole thing, despite the questions that remain unanswered. So, yeah, big issue, a lot of impacts, lives were lost, and it's going to take a long time. And I think the fact that it was captured on video really nailed home the horrific nature of it.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely, Colin. Thank you so much for joining us. I'd love to have a chat before the election, of course, in November. There's a lot of water to go under the bridge until then, isn't there?
Let's do it. Can't wait to come back.